Good morning, children. Today we are going to see 5th chapter, Molecular Genetics. BioSpark, that is our channel. You are asked to like it, share it. Today we see Human Genome Project, goals and methodologies of Human Genome Project, salient features of Human Genome Project, and DNA fingerprinting techniques. First one, Human Genome Project. Students, I hope you know the meaning for genome means that is all our genes together. That is the totality of the genes. And project, it is a series of tasks. So the meaning for the title Human Genome Project is an international scientific research project. So the meaning for Human Genome Project is it is an international scientific project with the goal of identifying and mapping of all genes of human genome from both a physical and functional standpoint. It was launched in the year 1990. Students, this may be asked for one more question. On what year the Human Genome Project was launched? It is 1990. It is considered as a mega project. And this also may be asked for two more questions. Why do we call the Human Genome Project as a mega project? Because it took nearly 13 years to complete. And moreover, the human genome is about 25 times larger than the genome of any other organisms. And the human genome is said to have approximately 3×10⁻⁹ base pair. That's why we consider the Human Genome Project as a mega project. What are the goals and methodologies of Human Genome Project? To identify all the genes in the human DNA, approximately 30,000 genes have been identified. To determine the sequence of 3 billion chemical base pair that make up human DNA. The chemical base pairs are thymine, adenine, cytosine and guanine. So these are all the chemical base pair. To store this information in the database. So it will be stored in the computer as a database. So it can be analyzed feature. So we can improve all the tools for the data analysis and that can be transferred to related technologies to other sectors such as industries. To address the ethical, legal, social issues that may arise from the project. The methodologies of Human Genome Project, we have two approaches. One is ETS and another one is sequence annotation. So when we compare these two approaches, the sequence annotation is somewhat better than ETS because in ETS, we analyze only the expressed sequence. That's why the sequence annotation is better than ETS. In sequence annotation, we approach all the DNAs, whether it is expressed or not expressed. So in ETS, the small pieces of DNA sequence may be analyzed, short single base sequence read from mRNA, and it is a conversion of RNA to DNA. And in the sequence annotation, it is coding and not coding sequence and later assigning different regions in the sequence with the functions. It describes regions or sites of interest in the protein sequence and it process of location of genes and marking specific features in DNA, RNA or protein sequence. That's why the sequence annotation is better than ETS. Now, how we can do the methodologies of Human Genome Project? For sequencing, the total DNA from a cell is isolated and then converted into random fragments of relatively smaller sizes. So we break that one into smaller sizes, very, very small fragments. After that, the small fragments will be cloned. So cloning is nothing but we amplify the numbers of the smaller fragments. So for that we have the host. Here we can use two types of host, One is bacteria and another one is yeast. And after that, we multiply that one by using a specialized vectors. The vectors are nothing but the cloning vehicle. The cloning vehicles are called vectors. Here we use BAC and OAC. What is BAC? Bacterial artificial chromosome. And OAC, yeast artificial chromosome. These two vectors can be used to increase the number of DNA fragments. So here we can amplify the DNA fragments. After that, the fragments are sequenced using automated DNA sequencer, then arranged using specialized computer based programs. These sequences were subsequently annotated. So now this method clearly describes about the annotation. So we didn't study the methodologies of ETS, we studied annotation approach. So in annotation method, we do the end. Students, these are all some sample questions you can go through. Thank you, children. We meet again in another lesson. Thank you.